In 2009, a group of graduate students from Florida Atlantic University set out to design an autonomous boat that would be capable of accurate, close-quarters navigation. And what the hell is an autonomous vehicle? Well, they're everywhere. In the air, underwater, and everywhere in between, with different designs and missions, including this, a robotic sailboat designed to track tropical storms, also developed at FAU. Back in 2008, we set out to tackle the problem of how to navigate an autonomous boat through a course of colored obstacles. Our first attempt, shown here, was appropriately named the Slug. It relied on a combination of waypoint navigation using GPS and dead reckoning using a digital compass. The Slug was less than perfect. Flaming speed! And the reason was that it relied on GPS. Imagine you're a robot boat, 4 feet long, using a typical civilian GPS unit that is accurate to plus or minus 10 feet to find a specific point on Earth. Where's the target? If you had eyes, you could find it. So we set out to build a boat with eyes, and the result was Guss. Guss is a tugboat. His constantly curious stereoscopic vision system makes him look, well, like... But unlike the 700-year-old Wally, Guss is a newborn, and must first learn how to see using a mathematical algorithm that we taught him. The process begins by getting Guss to track through a straight channel of red and white buoys. As an autonomous system, no human interaction occurs while Guss is underway, including any form of wireless communication. His right eye looks for red buoys while his left looks for white. No GPS or compass is used during these tests. So far, so good. The next task is to move the buoys into increasingly complex patterns in hopes that Guss will adapt to the changes and successfully navigate through the buoys. Listen closely, and you will hear Guss's two motors. When you hear a high pitch, it means that Guss is trying to turn to the left. A low pitch means he's trying to turn to the right. Watch as Guss slows down almost to a complete stop. He is waiting for visual confirmation of where the buoys are before he goes through them. The process is repeated many times with different buoy configurations. In this segment, watch as Guss successfully navigates between buoys that are only a few feet apart. This would not be possible with GPS-only navigation. thanks for watching. For more information, including our most recent research exploits, and information about how to study ocean science and engineering at FAU, visit www.oe.fau.edu.